artificial intelligence, machine learning. These emerging technologies are changing the way we live, work, and do business in the world for the better. How is AI actually being applied in business today, though? In this episode of UpTech Report, I interview Mason Levy with Swivl, whose aim is to simplify AI training by turning customer data into machine learning-ready models, whereas they call it a human-in-the-loop AI concept. Mason, thank you so much for joining me, man.
Appreciate yeah, thanks for having me again.
You got it. Yeah. So in 30 seconds, define how does your product help a business and who can best utilize it right now?
Yeah, ultimately, we typically sell into customer success teams and help automate the customer interactions through natural language understanding. So, you know, chatbots and voice bots on a phone.
And as far as the best type of people out there, how they start pulling it in, what's a good use case for them of immediately, like you often suggest, this is the first thing that really can help them with?
Yeah, I mean, I think onboarding onto a SaaS platform or e-commerce product recommendations, we're really good at those. And those are really great starting points to get started for us. It allows somebody to get their hands dirty with something that immediately provides value. And then, you know, we can kind of branch off into other avenues of automation with that business as they kind of learn the system a little bit better.
How would you say your product is different from other ones in the market?
I think our core competency is really in the feedback loop. So, you know, a lot of the products that are out on the market allow for a model to be built or for you to start to interact with your customers, but they're not learning. They're not getting smarter. And so we've kind of really doubled and tripled down on that feedback loop. So, you know, when the model isn't confident, escalate to a human, learn from that human to human interaction, and ultimately see the success of that model continue to increase over time.
Technology is awesome when it works. And when it doesn't, then people are like, oh, this is annoying, stupid machine. And that's why I find interesting that the human in the loop concept can help kind of carry over and carry that a bit more. But let's talk more about the actual technology behind your platform. How are you utilizing artificial intelligence and machine learning and other technologies?
Yeah. So, I mean, ultimately, we sit on top of natural language understanding models in order to, you know, determine intents within user examples or utterances, as you might would call them, as well as entities, and then routing them properly to, you know, automate the response, the business process, or escalate to the appropriate team. So in some cases, we're not actually automating a response. We're just actually identifying the intent and figuring out, should this go to the finance department or should it go to the customer success team?
Those who are trying to actually build then their own product and stuff out there using natural language processing and other things, any suggestions you would give for them on issues they may run into choosing or creating their own base for a type of technology?
Yeah, I mean, I think the hardest part is getting started. I think a lot of entrepreneurs, especially in the natural language area, will spend a lot of time, you know, building. And the best way to get feedback is put it out there, get live action, and then have some system that allows for that feedback loop to be closed. Again, something like Swivl really helps with that. We can plug into a lot of different channels, whether that be Slack, Microsoft Teams, WhatsApp, Skype, et cetera. And I think like the biggest hurdle is like, don't be scared to put it out in the world and let somebody give you some feedback there.
How many companies are you guys helping right now with your product?
We have 32 customers on the platform, everything from, you know, a 3-person team up to 100 people within a single large enterprise using it. So we're really excited about where we're at right now.
Where do you see yourself in 5 years, where Swivl's going to be?
Yeah, we really look for the Uberization of data labeling, right? And so I would love to walk into a coffee shop for a meeting and see somebody sitting down waiting for somebody else to meet with them using the Swivl application to label data for some large enterprise down the road.
What kind of hurdles then do you see in order to get to that point that you got to overcome and work through?
Yeah, I mean, I think any startup has 1,000 hurdles. You know, we're actively finding product market fit right now. And so, you know, some of the biggest things that we talk about internally is, you know, how do you sell a product that is pretty complicated? You need to have buy-in from multiple organizational units, whether that be the customer success or sales and marketing team, as well as the technical team that's going to be the ones that are helping implement. And so those are some of the headaches that we think about. You know, obviously startups, I always like to say the best entrepreneurs know how to let fires burn. There's more fires than any of us could put out in one day. And some of them we'll just have to sit there and let burn for a little while.
So how are you always staying on top and keep innovating as obviously the marketplace is changing and people are adapting, both competition, but your customers? How are you constantly innovating?
Yeah, I think, you know, going back to kind of what our core competency is about the feedback loop. We're always looking for feedback. You know, very critical feedback is great. How can we get better? Where did we fail? And then, you know, we spend a lot of time researching what's on the market, talking to people at the large corporations like Microsoft and Amazon and Google about what they're up to and how we could partner with them to be successful. And so, you know, constantly learning and being educated about what's happening and talking to people that are, you know, innovating in similar regions and kind of looking at, you know, what's happening in autonomous driving and where that piece of the market is going so that we can take bits and pieces of it and say, hey, look, that hasn't really been applied to this unstructured type of data yet. So how do we apply that?
So if somebody wanted to come and work with you of varying size of company, what are they looking at then expense-wise to be able to utilize your platform?
Yeah, the beauty of our system is that you can get started for free. We offer a free live chat. This allows for the data to come in and be in our training queue. As soon as you want to turn on the training, our first labs model starts at about $250. And then as we scale with volume, as well as the number of seats, you know, our enterprise models start around $5,000 a month. So we really have a price point that fits about just about everybody's needs.
Awesome. Thank you again for joining us today. For more information, where can people go and what's kind of the next step that you would recommend that they take?
Look at us at tryswivl.com. As I kind of mentioned, you can go in and sign up for live chat to kind of get into the tool and look at it, or reach out to me at mason@tryswivl.com. Happy to do a full demo, show you some of the use cases that have been successful and the ROI that our customers are already seeing using the product. Look forward to chatting with anybody that's interested.
Awesome. Thanks. Appreciate it, Mason.
Yeah, of course. Have a good one, man.
That was just one example of applied AI. Have you seen a company utilizing AI or machine learning to transform the way we all live, work, and do business? Leave a comment below and let us know.